You'll see an efficient and effective approach to designing your own electrical layout. I'll explain the infamous 6-12 rule for wiring, and I'll help you figure out when to use 12 gauge or 14 gauge wire, so be sure to stick around for that. Here's some of the tools and materials I'll be using for this part of the job. Many of these are linked in the description if you're interested. When I'm finished building out this space in the basement, it'll become a maker space, which is basically a cross between an engineering workshop and a crafting room. So I'm wiring it up like a typical residential bedroom with a couple extra receptacles. The first thing that you're going to need to do is decide where you want your light switches and outlets. You're going to install an electrical box like this one everywhere a switch or an outlet will be, so we're going to start there. I'm using all one gang boxes, which means they can hold one switch or one outlet. You'll want to use consistent heights when you're installing your light switches, and you do have a little bit of leeway for this. I would suggest that you match the height in the rest of your home for this. The switches in my home sit 48 inches from the floor to the top of the switch, so I'm going to mark 48 inches on the stud where I'm installing the electrical box. It's really important to remember to install your switches on the knob side of the door, not the hinge side. That way, when you open the door to the room, the switch is right there. A couple of things to notice about the electrical box. First, notice these half-inch tabs on the box. These are built into the box so that you set the box out from the stud the right distance by a half an inch. This will ensure that you're flush with drywall that'll be installed later. The box also has a couple nails that'll anchor it in place. When you have it where you want it, hammer it into place. I'll have three locations with switches in this room to control the lights. So I'll install all three in a similar fashion, on the knob side of the door, 4 feet up, with the electrical box sitting out from the stud a half an inch. To install electrical boxes for your outlets, again, you have a little bit of freedom here, and again, I would suggest staying consistent with the rest of your house. I'm installing my outlets at 16 inches from the floor. These boxes will be installed in the same way, a half inch out from the wall. You may have heard of the 6-12 rule for wiring, and you'll want to follow it to stay consistent with electrical codes, so I'll explain what it is now. I'll use a schematic of this room while I explain. I'm rounding to the nearest foot to simplify things. This is a huge room, 12 feet by 17 feet, with 3 doors and an inset space in front of the closet. Simply put, the 6-12 rule is all about outlet spacing, and it says there must be an outlet within 6 feet of each corner, and there can be no more than 12 feet between outlets on a wall. As long as we stay within these constraints, we're good to go. So, on the 17-foot long wall, I could get away with 2 outlets if I spaced each of them, say, 3.5 feet from the corners, so that they're 10 feet apart. I want 3 outlets along this wall, so I'm spacing my outlets about 2 feet from the corner and adding one in the middle. Rounding the corner, I have 8 feet of wall before the door. I'm going to place an outlet about 2 feet from the corner and about 2 feet from the door, which is more than is needed, but that's just fine. Again, no more than 6 feet from any corner, no more than 12 feet between outlets. I have 1 foot of space between the door and the next corner. I only need to include an outlet on walls that are 2 feet or longer. Since this is only a 1 foot space, I don't need an outlet here. And it wouldn't even make a lot of sense to put one here since the door will open in that direction. Rounding the corner, there's 6 feet of wall space between the door and the bathroom. Therefore, I'll need 1 outlet minimum on that wall, and I'll put it here. Rounding the corner to the inset space next to the closet, I have 2 feet of wall here and here, so I'll have an outlet on each. Finally, I have a 9-foot wall between this exterior door and the corner, so I'll be adding an outlet 1 foot from the corner. The 6-12 rule is met in each case, so the whole room meets code. But don't forget, check your local building codes with everything you're doing on your project. Now, since this room will be a maker space, I'm also adding some additional outlets similar to what you'd see in the kitchen. I'll add a secondary outlet above each outlet along the long wall at about 40 inches high. Please bear in mind as you're watching this that I am a science teacher by trade, not an electrician. I grew up in a construction family. I've been around this stuff my whole life, but it's not what I do for a living. So be sure to consult a licensed electrician on anything that doesn't make sense. Having said that, feel free to drop a comment below with any questions you may have, and I'd be happy to try to answer them. Okay, I'm running my outlets on a 20 amp circuit, so I'm gonna need 12 gauge wire for this. Let's start running wire. If this is a brand new supply, your feed will be coming from your breaker box. For the sake of this teaching, I'll be showing you what it looks like to run electricity from the first electrical box in your room. The Romex comes in spools for easy handling, but it's much easier to install if you go ahead and unravel it as it comes out of the spool. So I'm unraveling some on the front end. To get from one outlet to the next, I'm gonna need to go through studs. So I'm using my 20 volt DeWalt drill with a 1/2 inch bit for this. I like to keep things looking tidy, so I drill all of my holes at 20 inches from the floor. I'll go through each stud, separating my electrical boxes. Be sure to go through the center of the stud for this. When finished, I run my Romex from the first box to the next by feeding it through each stud. When you get to the next electrical box, you'll have to pop open one of the doors on the top of the electrical box and put the end of the wire through it. I pop it open with a screwdriver and hammer, but feel free to give it a shot with your hands if you have super powerful ninja thumbs. Feed the wire through the door to 6 to 8 inches beyond the box. Then go back to the first box and cut the wire so that the typical 6 to 8 inches can be pulled beyond the box. I'll continue this work from one electrical box to the next until all outlets are supplied with Romex. Before we go on, if you're seeing value in this content, all that I ask is that you would give this video a big thumbs up. It really helps the channel a ton and tells YouTube to send this video out to more people to view. Thank you so much. Let's get back to it. I'm running my lights on a 15 amp circuit, and so I'm gonna need 14 gauge wire for this. From here, if you're like me and you have more than one switch controlling your lights, you're gonna be running 14-3 wire between the electrical boxes. And I'll run it in a similar fashion to what I did with the 12-2 Romex, from one box to the next through studs. These wires need stapled to a stud no more than 6 inches from where they leave an electrical box. This way, they're very unlikely to get yanked out of the box. I'm using 1/2 inch staples for this 12-2 Romex. I can set multiple 12-2 wires on top of each other before stapling into place. I make sure to hammer the staples in until the wire's immobile. I staple all wires into place next to the electrical boxes and at least once every 4 feet when wires are traveling along a stud. The general setback rule for these cables is that they must be at least 1¼ inches back from the face of the framing members. If this requirement can't be met, you've got to protect the cables by installing a steel plate that fastens to the face of the framing centered over the cable location. When finished, you just fold over your wires coming out of the electrical boxes and tuck them into place. They'll receive receptacles and switches after the drywall is hung. Next step for me is planning out canless lighting in the ceiling above. If you'd like to see this makerspace build from the beginning, I've got a playlist that you can check out right there. If you'd like to subscribe to this channel to follow along as I continue building this space, click the ManCycle logo right there. Thank you for watching. See you next time.